The bitch queen shan't take me my joy. Ahoy, bellows and swallows my joy, ahoy.
Hey dudes and dudettes, this one is going to be pretty simple to follow along because positioning is the most important. We're in the Underdark, so I'm going to assume that you're level 4, reasonably geared, and sort of know what you're doing. I'll use Astarion, Shadowheart, and Lae'zel for simplicity and their dark vision. This is a minimalist general guide that should work every time, but I will leave some other helpful information in the pinned comment. Davai! The hook horrors have 62 HP, which might discourage some people from engaging with them, but they have an intelligence of 6, so we're going to use our superior ape brains to outmaneuver them. We see 4 of them in total, and the wizard Filro the Forgotten. There's a lot of high ground and a lot of shadows, so we'll utilize that to our advantage. 2 of the horrors can be easily bursted down without attracting the attention of the others. You can either approach from the low ground, under the tree, or you can approach through the beaver banks. We'll go through the beaver banks due to the vision cones of the patrols. First, blow out the beaver banks with fire and sneak in. One of the horrors patrols up the cliff and down below the tree. When it turns back from the cliff, follow it with everyone. When it passes the final step of the cliff in the corner, enter turn-based mode. Make sure to unclog everyone from the toilet chain to prevent unintentional character following. Position Astarion behind the horror and Lae'zel a little further away. Give Lae'zel the command to attack the horror and get a sneak attack ready with Astarion. While the attack animation is going off, use sneak attack and you will perform a double hit for the surprise round. Lae'zel and Astarion will roll for initiative and they may get in front of the horror, which will allow them to attack again. If they don't kill the horror in that round, you still have the rest of your party that can deal damage due to hiding in the darkness. However, you can skip the round and you can attack again because the horror is under the surprise effect. Good job, you've taken out one of them. Now let's approach the rest. Filro has some inconvenient spells, low health, and we don't want to deal with more variables than brute force. He and his bodyguard are our next targets. Use shadows as cover and sneak up the stairs with each character individually, because if movement is set to toilet chain mode, you might get spotted due to pathfinding into the horror's vision cone. There's a chance Filro will spot you while he's turning on his patrol, but he usually gives you a 12 second window to climb up. To circumvent doing everything all at once, you can use Astarion to go up and sneak attack on Filro while he's turned towards the cliff. This will trigger the surprise round, which stops time for everyone in the vicinity. You will notice that the bullet also joins the initiative order because the combat triggers it to come out in the middle of the map, pulling the aggro of the 2 other horrors. We'll use this as a distraction. Your other characters are in the shadows. Use this sequence to freely move up since they're out of combat. Position them at the high ground and bless yourself with the power of friendship. Finish Filro if he's not dead already and focus on the horror that's right in front of you. Don't push Filro in the depths if you want the icy crystal, because if he falls, he doesn't drop it. The horror should be able to go down by using only basic attacks, since it's 4 against 1, but use whatever attacks you deem necessary for how the situation plays out. The other 2 horrors are distracted by the bullet, and one of 2 things will happen. Either the bullet kills one of the horrors and runs away, or it buys you 2 to 3 more rounds to deal damage while it tanks. If you're lucky with the rolls, it might even kill everyone for you. Position your party at the edge of the cliff and use whatever range attacks you have to deal damage. Don't worry about firing with disadvantage, since you have time on your side and a superior fighting position. If you line up everybody at the edge in a line, the horrors might not be able to clip everyone when they jump to you. If you position your party a little further away from the edge, you might force them to circle around while you shoot them from outside your weapon range. When and if they reach you, they will be at such low health that almost any offensive method will work. But be careful, because their attacks can push you or multi-attack you if you're prone. The rewards for this fight are the Icy Crystal from Filro and the Susar Bark from the tree, which allows you to forge a Susar plus one weapon from the forge in the Blighted Village. Thanks for watching, dudes. I hope you learned something. Have fun and have a beautiful day.